This is a springtail standing on water. It's a tiny creature, only about 2.5 millimeters long, but it can do this. Flick its spring-loaded tail down to deform the water surface and fling itself up and away. Some species, like this isotoma, can walk on the water too, but jumping is their main way of getting around quickly and avoiding predators. I just happened to be out on a walk in the woods when I came across them hanging out on the surface of this small stream. What I noticed with these semi-aquatic ones was that jumping on the water surface isn't an easy thing. Watch what happens to this one when its antennae are wet and locked up in the surface tension of the water. The jump is kind of a disaster. There's a different type of springtail, one closely related to that species, that's way better at jumping on water. A couple months ago, my colleagues over at Georgia Tech published this research paper describing the tricks an isotoma species uses to jump off water. This is their footage of that springtail, and the special thing it does is this. It uses capillary action to grab a droplet of water when it takes off. But before I tell you why it does that, let me show you one thing that can go wrong when a springtail jumps on water. At the top of the frame is a globular springtail, and at the bottom is one of the ones I showed you at the beginning of this video. Both their jumps start out great, but the problem happens when they land. Their bodies get stuck in the surface of the water and they float off until they can bump into something or shift their weight around enough to right themselves. What the researchers of this new study noticed was that their springtails seem to always land belly and feet first, ready to jump again. Filming their landings in the lab, they saw them come down, absorb the impact, and remain anchored to the water's surface. Watching this up close, they saw this structure, the collophore, or ventral tube, was what was sticking to the water and stabilizing their landings. When the springtails would miss and land on their sides, they'd bounce up off the water and only stabilize once that ventral tube made contact and stuck them feet down and right side up. When filming this species taking off, they also noticed the collophore was being used to hold a bead of water. This has the effect of lowering the center of gravity of the springtail, which, along with a U-shaped posture they get into while in the air, stabilizes their bodies and sends them down belly first. Because of this, in 85% of the jumps they filmed, the springtails land the right way. In a last step, the research team built a simple kind of robot to demonstrate that a lowered center of gravity paired with a U-shaped body posture could orient and direct the landings of a spring-powered machine. Here you see the robot come down belly first, just like the springtails. The species I came across in the forest, the one I showed you at the beginning of this video, doesn't jump nearly as high or as far as the ones in this new study. But I was able to capture one sequence that shows that they might be using the same ventral tube water droplet trick. Watch the ventral tube right here interact with the water as the springtail jumps. You can see it draw up the water surface and then detach right as the tail goes down and the jump begins. So I thought this research paper was really great, and I'll put a link to it in the video description so you can go read it for yourself. I'm glad the authors shared with me their videos so I could tell this story here. I've actually been collaborating with some of the same group to study the jumps of terrestrial springtails. So you can look forward to even more videos like this coming out on this channel in the future. Thanks for watching.